Hi, my name is Mirabelle Ilume. I'm a 42-year-old mother of two. I just had my second baby 6 months ago, and I do workout videos on the mini stepper. So you guys have asked, how do we do the waistline workout that I do a lot? You see me moving my hips a lot. You see me move my waistline a lot on lots of those videos. And I've encouraged you guys to do that as well, because it helps to snatch your waistline. It helps to flatten your stomach. It helps with your glutes. It helps with your thighs. It aids to tone those areas of the body. So if you're trying to tone your stomach, you're trying to tone your midsection, then that's just something you want to do when you're on the mini stepper. So I'm going to show you how it looks like from the front. Then I'll show you how to get it done from the side and show you how far the stepper has to go down so it doesn't hit the lower panel. Because a lot of people have also asked, why does it hit the lower panel of the mini stepper? No, it does not. If your stepper is hitting the lower panel, it can be one or two reasons. Either your stepper, your weight is very close to the weight limit capacity of the stepper. That means you got a stepper that is very close to your weight. And so when you step on it, it's going to take it all the way down to the lower panel. And so you're going to not have the full body workout that you need on that stepper. The second reason might be that you're pressing it too hard. You're pushing it with all your force for it to hit the lower panel. There is no need for you to do that. Leave it halfway. Push the stepper down, but you're going to stop halfway. You're going to stop at 3/4. So you don't hit the lower panel. That way you get enough workout because you're holding the resistance and your thighs are getting some workout. And so your other parts of your body focus more on different muscle groups when you're stepping, instead of worrying about the stepper hitting the lower panel. The stepper is manual. Every time you step on it, every time you push it down, it manually brings your feet back up. So when you step on it, it brings your feet manually back up. So focus more on targeting different muscle groups. Like right now, if I lean backwards, I am feeling the muscles. I feel the burn around my thighs. And so I'm focusing more on either tightening those muscles. So I feel the burn. I feel the resistance. I feel the workout. I tone my thighs muscles more because I can feel it. If I want to work my glutes, I'm going to lean forward. I feel the muscles around my glutes engage. I lean forward and I keep moving. I'm stepping. Mind you, the intent is that your feet keep pressing down on the stepper and the stepper brings it back right up. So you press it down and the stepper brings it right back up. You lean forward, you hold your head up and you keep moving. The intent is that you want to keep your feet moving on the stepper. Let's say you have just 15 minutes to work out. For that 15 minutes, your feet should be moving. You should be exerting pressure. You should be pressing down on the mini stepper the entire time in order for you to get the full body workout on the mini stepper. So since we are talking about the waistline more today, I'm going to show you how I get the waistline done in a very slower mood. So I'm going to get back off the stepper and I get on it. I hope this is not too far for you to see it. I'll try to see if I can zoom it in. You get on the stepper. When you press down, this feet is up, this leg is up. When I press it down, I'm raising this muscle. I'm raising this muscle around the hip bone. I'm bringing up my hip bone. And when I take it down, I take the hip bone down. So that's the motion I'm doing when I'm moving my midsection. While vacuuming my stomach, mind you, my stomach is vacuumed. It's sucked in. My midsection engages in the workout. I can feel it. Put your hand on it. You'll feel the muscles. I mean, you feel the bones around that area moving as well as the muscles. Put your hand in front of your stomach. You also feel the muscles engage as well. That's how you know you're actually engaging those muscles in the workout. So when your feet goes down, you press down, lift the hip bone. When you bring it up, put down the hip bone. The hip bone comes up with the feet, with your leg coming up, and it goes down when your leg is going down. So you do that motion and you engage the upper body in it. You give the upper body some motions as well. Keep the motion going. Keep it slowly until you pick a rhythm you can work with. When you get a good rhythm, then you start moving your waist a little bit faster. following the rhythm of the stepper. Move your waist from left to the right. Move it. Move it. Have fun with it. Move it. Move it. Move that body. Move it. Mind you, you're still vacuuming your midsection. And you're engaging different muscle groups. You're engaging your thighs. You feel the muscles around your thighs. You feel that on that around your glutes and your waistline. Move it. Move it. Move it. It's a lot of fun. Then play your favorite music in the background. Have fun with it and keep moving. Move it. Move it. Move it. Have fun with it. Just do this continuously for about 5 minutes. And by the time you do it consistently, it's going to flow. Mind you, your waistline needs a little bit of lubrication. So you're lubricating it, you're making it lighter, you're getting it involved in the workout. It's going to hurt sometimes. It depends on how much your posture is. But if you find a good posture and you do it slowly and figure out the right rhythm that works with you, then it will not hurt. We're going to try to do that from the side, and hopefully you see it in a better angle and be able to figure it out so you don't hurt yourself. My intent is that we are safe. Safety first. Put on slip resistance shoes. Put on supportive bras. Have your body floating on the stepper. Then you can do other moves. So let's turn the stepper to the side so we see how this movement looks from the side. All right, I'm going to go down. I grab the stepper and I'll turn it to the side. Okay, hopefully we are still connected. Guys, I do my videos on one take. I don't like to edit videos. What you see is what I do. I don't like to edit it. So I'll do one take and that's it. Watch the stepper. That's why I left the dumbbells at the back. So you can actually see that it doesn't hit the lower panel. Watch how low it goes. Keep your head up. Keep your shoulders up. Mimic your walking style. Then move your waistline. Move it. Move that waist. Move your waistline. Suck it in. Move it. Move that waistline. Move it. Flow with it. Flow with it. Trim that waistline. Snatch it. Feel good. Love it. Move it. Enjoy it. Move your body. Move it. Move it. Move it. Move it. Love it. Love it. You see that? Then you walk upright. As you walk upright, mind you, you're just mimicking your walking style when you're walking on the stepper. Plus, the mini stepper doesn't touch the lower panel. The lower panel doesn't touch the bottom panel of the stepper. So you keep your head up. Move that waistline. Move it. Move it. Move it. Move it. Move it. Move that waistline. Move it, move it, move it, suck it in, move it, have fun with it, have fun with it, lean forward, keep it going. That will be a full session on your waistline. Thank me later. You will enjoy every bit of it. It is possible to get your body worked completely, full body workout on the mini stepper. You'll stay safe, stay blessed. Stay positive. Be the best versions of yourselves. God bless you. See you on another video. See you later. God bless you.